The box plot is procedure of displaying the distribution of data based on 5-number summary, that is minimum value, maximum value, first quartile, median, third quartile. This tutorial is to show you how to make a box plot with plus and minus error bar with Excel 2013. This graph is mostly used for statistical purpose, but the people of other subject may use it as an analysis tool. The box plot tells you the shape of the distribution, how spread out the values are, and detecting outliers. Here we consider 15 data points. These are the data points. In step 1, we compute first quartile, median, third quartile, interquartile range, lower whisker, upper whisker. We do not compute maximum and minimum value, because we know the outlier lies either below the lower whisker or above the upper whisker. So we do not compute maximum and minimum value. So, instead of maximum and minimum value, we compute lower whisker and upper whisker for drawing a box plot. For first quartile, we use quartile function. First give equal sign, then quartile, first bracket open, select data set, comma. For first quartile, we insert 1 and then bracket close, enter. So 14.4 is a first quartile. Next, for median, use function quartile, first bracket open, select data set, comma, 2 for median, then enter. We get median, that is 14.6. For third quartile, use function quartile, first bracket open, select data set, comma, for third quartile we insert 3 and then enter. So 14.8 is a third quartile. For interquartile range, the formula is Q3 minus Q1. So first we insert equal sign, then insert the value Q3, which is in G9, cell number G9, then insert minus, and then insert the value Q1, which is in cell number G7. Then enter, we get interquartile range, that is 0.4. For lower whisker, the formula is Q1 minus 1.5 interquartile range. So for this, first we enter equal sign, then enter the value of Q1, which is in G7, minus 1.5 star interquartile range, which is in cell number G10, and then enter. We get the lower whisker with the value is 13.8. For upper whisker, first we give equal sign, then select Q3 plus 1.5 star interquartile range, which is in G10, and then enter. So we get upper whisker, that is 15.4. So for first quartile, we use quartile, then select data, 1 for first quartile, then median, use quartile, select data, 2 for median. For third quartile, use quartile, select data, 3 for third quartile. For interquartile range, Q3 minus Q1, and lower whisker, Q1 minus 1.5 into interquartile range. For upper whisker, Q3 plus 1.5 into interquartile range. So we get these values in that way. Now we go to step 2. In step 2, we compute lower whisker, Q1 minus lower whisker, Q2 minus Q1, Q3 minus Q2, upper whisker minus Q3. These 5 values are required to draw the box plot. Lower whisker we already computed in step 1, so we just recall this value from step 1. that is 13.8, which is in cell number G11. Next, we compute Q1 minus lower whisker. First, we enter equal sign, then select Q1 value minus lower whisker, which is in cell number K6, then enter. So, 0.6 is a Q1 minus lower whisker. Next, we compute Q2 minus Q1. Q2 is in cell number G8 minus Q1 in cell number G7, then enter, we get 0.2, which is Q3 minus Q1. Again, for Q3 minus Q2, give equal sign, then select Q3 minus Q2, which is in cell number G8, and enter, we get the value Q3 minus Q2, which is 0.2. Now, for upper whisker minus Q3, first we select the value of upper whisker, which is in G12, minus Q3, which is in G9. Then enter, we get the value upper whisker minus Q3, that is 0.6. Now, we use this 5 value to draw a box plot. The step 1 is, first we select this 5 value, then go insert option, and then from insert option we go insert column chart, and then we select second diagram. So we get this diagram. The first bar represent lower whisker, second bar is Q1 minus lower whisker, third bar is Q2 minus Q1, fourth bar is Q3 minus Q2, fifth bar is upper whisker minus Q3. Now, click on this chart and then right click, go select data set data, and then go switch row to column and then press OK. Then we get this diagram. So again we describe this step as follows. First, we select this data set, this 5 data points, then go insert option, then go insert column chart, select second diagram, and get this chart. Then right click on this diagram, go select data, and then switch row to column and get this diagram and click OK. So now we get this diagram. So first portion is lower whisker, second portion is Q1 minus lower whisker, third portion is Q2 minus Q1, fourth portion is Q3 minus Q2, fifth portion is upper whisker minus Q3. Now, we select first portion of this chart. Then right click on it, go format data series, then select fill and line, then select no fill, then we get this. Now, select the second portion of this chart. Go add chart element, go error bars, then go more error bar options, then select minus, then we get this error bar. Now again we select the second portion of this chart, then go format data series, go fill and line, then go no fill. So we get this. Now again we select the top portion of this chart and right click on it, go format data series, go fill and line, then go no fill and get this. Now select the fourth portion of this chart, then go add chart element, then go error bars, more error bar options, and then select plus, then we get this error bar. Now select again the fourth portion of this chart, then right click on it, format data series, then go fill and line. First select no fill under fill, and then select no solid line under border, and choose the color red, black. Similarly, for third portion of this chart, right click on it, then go format data series, go fill and line, first select no fill under fill, select solid line under border, select color black, and then we get this portion. So this first portion of this box represent Q2 minus Q1, the second portion of this box represent Q3 minus Q2, this line or error bar represent upper whisker minus Q3, this error bar represent Q1 minus lower whiskers. Any value lies outside this line or this line are outliers. From this diagram we observe that the difference of Q3 and Q2 and the difference from Q2 and Q1 are same. So the shape of the distribution is symmetric. Now I want to remove this label from horizontal axis. For this, first we select this and then right click on it, and then go format axis, and then go labels under tick marks, then select none under label positions, then this one is removed. Now we want to give the chart title. Here we just use box plot for this title. Now our box plot is ready. So thank you.